So what are some trends that we can expect to see at Mobile World Congress?
You want to pay attention to the smartphone size, because you know phablets aren't going to go away, and some people are certainly going to be pushing the envelope. Can you have a 6-inch, 6.5, 7? I mean, things that rival the size of a tablet. But for everybody else out there, I think the bigger concentration is, what can we do with these things? How are you going to be able to connect your smartphone to your home, your business, your wearable, and all these other IoT type systems? Because there's a lot of intelligence going to those areas of people's lives, and the smartphone is going to be one of those touch points that you're going to be able to connect to them. So expect those kinds of trends coming up. For the smartphone market, there's Samsung and there's Apple, then there's everybody else, okay? So now you have a number of vendors who are gonna be competing within different tiers, where some of the Samsungs and the Apples can't really compete. I mean, if you take a look at where Motorola and LG and Nokia / Microsoft have made bets, they're going deeper and deeper into, hey, we're gonna have low-cost devices below $150, below $100. So now they're able to approach more customers on their terms rather than the company's own terms, in terms, at least as far as pricing goes. But at the same time, you look at some of these other companies, they're diversifying away from just smartphones. Okay, HTC, they announced a partnership with Under Armour back at CES. I'm expecting we're going to see some more clarity around the company's wearables strategy. The market for smartphones costing less than $150, it exploded. last year, to the tunes of hundreds of millions of units. But we want to take a look at how you're going to serve those low-cost customers with low-cost devices in places like China and India and Africa, Middle East, all over.
You mentioned China and the Chinese vendors like Huawei and ZTE and the others, but we haven't seen a lot of them in the U.S. What's going to happen there?
Slow steps, okay? This U.S. market, we are very much, used to the brands that we're seeing, the Samsungs and the Apples, to an extent, the Nokias and the Motorolas and the LGs. Everybody has an eye towards the United States, because if you can make it in the U.S. market, you can make it just about anywhere, too. And so, the keys are going to be, which carrier is going to be able to, get partnerships with, how many devices can you get there, at what price points, and how often can you refresh them. Now, here's the last point that you want to bring up is, what are you going to do differently than what Samsung and Apple and Moto Nokia have already done? Because people have been through those movie reels before. Okay, so we need to see a lot of a differentiation. My bet is going to be on price. If you can get a high-end phone for less than, say, $300 or less than $200, you're going to have a number of segments approaching you, even though they don't know your name brand as well and as popularly as some of the other brands that we're used to.